Hi guys, it's Juno again, and this is another video of how to remove a mortise lock from the door. Now I will cover this kind of mortise knob. I will cover this mortise lock set. This type is automatic locking. What I mean with an automatic locking is that it is only one way. From the inside part of the door, it is always free, and from the outside it is always locked. It can only be bevel bolt can only be extracted by means of the key. Okay, and this kind of lock also has a feature of anti-prying quality. With this if this is depressed or covered by the latch bolt, by the latch cuts installation, then this bevel bolt will not be extracted by means of inserting a card to retract it. It can only be retracted by the knob or by the key. Okay, see that? Can only be retracted by the knob inside and by the key outside. So this is an automatic locking type, and the procedure of this is a little bit not so difficult, but it has to be in a sequence. First you have to remove the two screws on the cover plate. And now need to remove the cover plate. And after that, after this is open, there is a screw from this side here inside that holds this rim cylinder here. So you have to loosen it, this is the retaining screw of the rim cylinder. Okay, so then after it is loosened, then you can loosen this by turning it until it is removed. Okay, and after that, from the inside part of the knob, there is a small hole here. As you can see, there is a small hole here from the inside. You have to loosen that. There is nothing to depress. This is the tightening nut of the knob, so you'll have to remove that by means of a spanner. So we'll loosen this. Okay, once it's loosened, you can loosen it by hand. And now, as you can see, the knob is being taken out. And after that, you have to loosen this again to remove the retaining holder here. This is another part. Right? Okay, and remove this guide here, and then you can pull out the whole handle. Okay, so once the handle is removed, I will show you from the inside. You have to loosen this. There is a thread here. You take out the plastic There is a thread here. Okay, and there is also a screw that holds this mortise lock. This is the guard. Okay, you can loosen this now, and you can also remove it. Insert an long nose and try to turn it. If it is too hard to turn by hand, okay. Now this is the part that has been removed. Now from this side, it's already flush, so that's finished. So we'll turn it around again. We'll start from the outside, and you have to loosen this also. The same thing from the inside. Okay, you see the screw there. Okay. You have to remove these two screws. This is the one holding the mortise cylinder nicely and in place for the handle. Okay, after that you have to remove this by turning it. Okay, so that has been removed. Now the last thing you do to remove it is to remove the these two screw on the face plate. This is the last screw to be removed, and make sure to mark it up so that when you return it, you will not be missing something. Okay, now that is removed, and now the lock is ready to be taken out. Okay, so this is a Sargent, a 77.04 model, I think, and this is an automatic locking type. That means when this is locked, when the door is closed and this hits the latch cuts, the door is automatically locked from the outside, and it can be only opened by means of the key. Okay friends, so that's all for this kind of mortise locks, and this is a Sargent bevel bolt with a double locking feature that will prevent it from frying. Okay, so thanks for watching and good day.